Hello everyone, and welcome to the Stratoscale Hybrid DevOps Pros. I'm Ariel, I'm here with Liaz.
Hi Ariel.
And we're talking about Kubernetes on Symphony 4.2.6. And we created a Kubernetes cluster, and now we want to deploy a Kubernetes app with ELBs.
Yes.
So
let's just deploy the first phase of a very simple Hello World web application.
Okay.
It will be just a web server saying hi and stating the host name.
Fantastic.
So again, we have our running Kubernetes cluster. It has two nodes, and right now there's no application. I'll be using kubectl, but just to remind you, we also have direct access to the Kubernetes UI if that's what you want. So kubectl, it points into a public IP. I got that, by the way, directly from our UI. Stated here.
So this is the IP address for my cluster.
Yes. This, by the way, was created using an Elastic IP because I've created the Kubernetes cluster
inside of a VPC.
I asked the Terraform to allocate Elastic IP, and that's exactly what I allocated for the Kubernetes. And the allocation was done in the UI in the menu.
Yeah.
Okay. So there you go. I can use kubectl.
Okay.
I got the node. Okay, great. So I have here, I asked the Kubernetes to go ahead and...
I think you need replicas.
Yes. So, no, it's okay. I already ran it correctly. So now I'll run this operation. It will actually download from Docker Hub the Hello World application in one replica. I have two nodes, but we're going to scale soon. And then that replica, we're just gonna run, and it's already running, by the way. So let's do get pod. So the application is running. Let's go ahead and see it. We can take that. Code and go 8080. Okay, so nothing will run. Why? Because the service is not exposed yet. Let's expose it. So the type is node port. Okay, it will be significant in there. That's just the name I'm giving my service, Hello World service. Okay.
Okay,
now it's exposed. Again, let's get there. Let's see how the service is exposed. So it is exposed through this TCP port 31555. Let's see that in action. So I'll give that port here, 31555.
Oh,
that's it. So that's our application.
Fantastic.
We have one pod, so we want to scale it up.
Yep.
So let's see how easy it is. We're just gonna see what's the rollout status. Deployment, Hello World. Sorry, I forgot the word status. It's rolled out.
Okay.
So now let's scale it. Again, it's going to be very easy. Just use the kubectl command. Scale. Replicas is this time 2. Scaled. Let's see what the roll status. It says, okay, one out of two is ready and the other one is scaling.
Kubernetes makes my life so easy.
Yeah, just imagine you need to scale 10, 20. Again, so scale out is successful and rollout is correct. Let's just check our pods here. And you can see two hello world
pods.
Pods. How are we going to access that? So let's go again and look at
the... And they're
running
on two different hosts.
Yeah, they're running on two different host names. And so if I refresh here, I'll always get the same host name because it's exposed to...
So how can we balance between them?
Okay, so the best way to balance is to use a load balancer. Symphony has its own load balancer running inside. Actually, that's an ELB. We're using the ELB. So let's go back to the Terraform.
Fantastic. So we have we're going to have an application running inside of Kubernetes, and we're going to use an ELB running inside of the VPC to load balance that application.
Yes. So I have this one already done. Let's just ask the load balancer to load balance specific port we've done before. It's right here, 31555.
Oh, that's the port that we got.
Yes.
Service.
Mm-hmm. And just running apply. I'm running apply. That apply will actually update the first application we ran using Terraform. That's the whole point of Terraform. No changes. Changes will only happen to what I'm asking to change. The rest of the VPC is perfectly intact and running.
Makes our life so easy.
Yes, it is. Every infrastructure as code makes our life easy, especially in the terms of DevOps. Okay, so here it is. Load balancer is creating. Let me just show you the creation inside the context of the VPC. Go to networking. Here you can see there it is. So load balancer already deploying.
Yep.
We'll go ahead and deploy it. So it is spawning. What we need to do is it will spawn using a target group, but the target group will be empty. We need to connect the load balancer into the nodes that are hosting the Kubernetes.
So let's configure the load balancer.
So let's configure that. So the load balancer will be spawning. Now it's already active. We'll go ahead, modify. We're going to say the instance is the Kubernetes.
Yep.
Let's add another one.
Oh, so easy.
We're finishing. Yep. And that's a load balancer. That's the floating IP that we have. Actually, that's an elastic IP I created using the Terraform. Again, super easy. Exposed. There you go. So if I'm going to refresh, you can see several host names.
Yeah.
And this is it. So it's a unified solution using Terraform, infrastructure as code, ELB, VPC, Kubernetes, big names and everything on-prem. That's actually in our lab, right down the hall.
So we just saw how we can deploy an application inside Kubernetes and hook it up with an ELB using Terraform. Gorgeous.
Super easy.
All inside of a VPC.
Yes.
Nice.
Thank you very much.